Solving quadratic equation by completing the square. As a prerequisite knowledge of this lesson, you need to study the following topics: perfect square trinomial, multiplying binomials, factoring, and extracting square root. Please see the links of videos in the description box. Let's start. Example 1. Find the roots of the equation 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0 by completing the square. Solution. First, write again the given equation, which is 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0. Next, we need to make sure that the first term has a numerical coefficient of 1. Since the first term is 2x squared, we need to make the numerical coefficient to 1. What will we do now is to divide the whole equation into 2. So, the result is x squared plus 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. The next step is, we need to transpose the negative 8 to the other side by applying the addition property of equality by adding the inverse of negative 8. The inverse of negative 8 is positive 8. So, we will add both sides of the equation by positive 8. So we have x squared plus 2x, negative 8 plus 8 is equal to 0, then equal to 8. So we have now an equation x squared plus 2x is equal to 8. I will write again for you to be followed the step. Now, we will proceed to perform the perfect square trinomial. We will find the third term of the equation. As I said a while ago, try to study or review the topics that I have given. It also shows step-by-step process in getting the third term. So, try visit the link of the videos that is written on the description box for you to understand the process of getting the third term. For now, I just only showing the solution. So the third term is positive 1. Then, we will now add positive 1 on both sides of the equation. The equation now is x squared plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 9. Now, we need to factor x squared plus 2x plus 1. The factors are x plus 1 multiplied by x plus 1 is equal to 9. We need to simplify the factors x plus 1 and x plus 1 into x plus 1 square is equal to 9. Since we were looking for the value of x, the square makes the equation complicated. We need to remove the square by using the method extracting the square root. What will we do now is, we insert both sides of the equation by a radical sign. We can now cancel the radical sign and the square. Cancel and cancel is equal to the square root of 9. The equation now is x plus 1 is equal to. The square root of 9 is positive and negative 3. Since our target is to find the value of x, we need to transpose the positive 1 on the other side of the equation. Simply, the inverse of positive 1 is negative 1. Then we will add both sides of the equation. Then we have x plus 1 minus 1 is 0. Equal to negative 1 positive and negative 3. Or simply x is equal to negative 1 positive and negative 3. Equation x is equal to negative 1 positive and negative 3 can be separated into two equation. We have x is equal to negative 1 plus 3 and the other is, x is equal to negative 1 minus 3. For the first equation, the value of x is 2, and for the second equation, the value of x is negative 4. Let's move in checking. In checking will determine if the value of x is a solution of the equation or not. To start, let x is equal to 2. Get the original equation, which is 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0. Substitute the value of x, which is 2, in the equation. We have 2 multiplied by 4. Because 2 squares are equal to 4, plus 8, 4 multiplied to 2 is equal to 8, minus 16 is equal to 0. We have 8 plus 8 minus 16 is equal to 0. Then 16 minus 16 is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 2 is a solution or root of the equation 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0. Let us also check, the x is equal to negative 4. Get the original equation, which is 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0. Next, let's substitute the value of x in the equation, which is negative 4. Now, we have 2 multiply to 16, 16 because negative 4 square is equal to 16. Minus or negative 16, negative 16 because positive 4 multiplied by negative 4 is equal to negative 16, then minus 16 is equal to 0. We have 32, 2 multiply to 16 is 32 minus 16 minus 16 is equal to 0. 16 minus 16 is equal to 0. 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, negative 4 is a solution of the equation 2x squared plus 4x minus 16 is equal to 0. Example number 2. What are the solutions of the equation x squared minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0? Solution. Rewrite the equation x squared minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Since the numerical coefficient of the first term is 1, no need to simplify. Let us proceed to transpose positive 9 to the other side using the addition property of equality. So we need to add the inverse of positive 9. The inverse of positive 9 is negative 9. So, we will add negative 9 both sides of the equation. Now, the equation is x squared minus 10, positive 9 minus 9 is equal to 0, then equal to negative 9. We have x squared minus 10x is equal to negative 9. Now, we will transform the equation into perfect square trinomial. As shown in the solution, the third term is 25. Then, we will add 25 both sides of the equation to maintain the equality of the equation. The equation is x squared minus 10x plus 25. Negative 9 plus 25 is equal to 16. Then, the equation is x squared minus 10x plus 25 is equal to 16. We need now to factor the equation x squared minus 10x plus 25. The factors are x minus 5 multiply to x minus 5. Then equal to 16. Next, simplify the factors x minus 5 multiply to x minus 5 into x minus 5 square is equal to 16. As you can see, the square makes the equation more difficult for you. So, we need to remove the square by applying extracting the square root. We need to insert radical signs on both sides of the equation. We can now cancel the radical sign and square. The equation is x minus 5. The square root of 16 is positive and negative 4. Since we were looking for the value of x, we need to transpose the negative 5 to the other side of the equation, by adding the inverse of negative 5. The inverse of negative 5 is positive 5. Then, x plus, negative 5 plus 5 is equal to 0, then, equal to 5 positive and negative 4. Then, we have x is equal to 5 positive and negative 4. Now, we will separate the equation into two equations. One is x is equal to 5 plus 4 and the other is x is equal to 5 minus 4. The value of x is equal to 9 and other is, x is equal to 1. Let's proceed in checking the values of x. Let x is equal to 9. Copy the original equation, which is x squared minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Now, we will substitute the value of x, which is 9, in the given equation. 9 squares is equal 81 minus, 10 multiply 9 is equal to negative 90 plus 9 is equal to 0. We have 81 minus 90 is equal to negative 9, plus 9 is equal to 0. Negative 9 plus 9 is equal to 0. then 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 9 is a solution or root of the equation x square minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Next is, let x is equal to 1. Copy the original equation, which is, x square minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Now, we will substitute the value of x, which is 1, in the given equation. 1 square is equal 1 minus, negative 10 multiply 1 is equal to negative 10, plus 9, is equal to 0. Then, we have 1 minus 10 is equal to negative 9, plus 9, is equal to 0. Negative 9 plus 9 is equal to 0. Then, 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 1 is a solution or root of the equation x square minus 10x plus 9 is equal to 0. Example number 3. Find the solutions of the equation x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Solution. First, we will write the given equation, which is, x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Since the first term has a coefficient of 1, we will now proceed to transpose the positive 9 into the other side of the equation using the addition property of equality. So, we will add the inverse of positive 9, which is negative 9, on both sides of the equation. So, we have x square minus 8 plus 9 minus 9 is equal to 0, then equal to negative 9. Then simply the equation becomes, x square minus 8x is equal to negative 9. Let us now move in transforming the equation into perfect square trinomial. As shown in the solution in getting the value of the third term. The third term is positive 16. Then we will add, positive 16 on both sides of the equation. Next, factor equation x square minus 8x plus 16. Then, the factors are x minus 4 multiplied to x minus 4. Then equal to, negative 9 plus 16 is equal to 7. Let's simplify the factors, x minus 4 multiplied to x minus 4, so, we have x minus 4 squares, then equal to 7. Next, we will do extracting square root both sides of the equation. Then cancel the radical sign and square. Then, the equation is x minus 4 is equal to the positive and negative square root of 7. The square root of 7, because, 7 is not a perfect square. Therefore, it remains its square root of 7. Next, since our target is to get the values of x, then we need to transpose the negative 4 to the other side, by adding the inverse of negative 4. The inverse of negative 4, is positive 4. Then x plus negative 4 plus positive 4 is equal to 0, then equal to 4, positive and negative square root of 7. Then finally, we have, x is equal to 4, positive and negative square roots of 7. Let us now separate the equation. X is equal to 4, plus the square root of 7, and the other is, x is equal to 4, minus the square root of 7. Let us check, if the values of x, is a solution to the given equation. Let's start with, let x is equal to 4, plus the square root of 7. Use the original equation x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Let us substitute the value of x in the equation, which is 4, plus the square root of 7. 4, plus the square root of 7 square. You can get the product of 4, plus the square root of 7 square, through the vertical way of getting the product of binomial, or through the FOIL method. To know more about this, try to visit the links of videos that I have written on the description box. So the product is 16 plus 8 square root of 7 plus 7. 8 multiply 4 is equal to negative 32. Then 8 multiply to the square root of 7. The product is negative 8 square root of 7 plus 9. Then equal to 0. The next step is, combine like terms, wherein we just arrange similar terms and combine them. Remember, If you arrange terms on one side of the equation, there is no changing of a sign. So, we have 16 plus 7 minus 32 plus 9, plus 8 square root of 7 minus 8 square root of 7 then equal to 0. Then, we have 16 plus 7 minus 32 plus 9 plus 8 square root of 7 minus 8 square root of 7 is equal to 0, then equal to 0. Then the result is 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 4 plus the square root of 7 is a solution of the equation x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Let us check also the other value of x. Let's start with, let x is equal to 4, minus the square root of 7. Use the original equation x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Let us substitute the value of x in the equation, which is 4, minus the square root of 7. 4, minus the square root of 7 square. You can get the product of 4, minus the square root of 7 square, through the vertical way of getting the product of binomial, or through the FOIL method. To know more about this, try to visit the links of videos that I have written on the description box. So the product is 16 minus 8 square root of 7 plus 7. Negative 8 multiply 4 is equal to negative 32. Then 8 multiply to the negative square root of 7. The product is positive 8 square root of 7 plus 9. Then equal to 0. The next step is, combine like terms, wherein we just arrange similar terms and combine them. Remember, if you arrange terms on one side of the equation, there is no changing of a sign. So, we have 16 plus 7 minus 32 plus 9, plus 8 square root of 7 minus 8 square root of 7 then equal to 0. Then, we have 16 plus 7 minus 32 plus 9 plus 8 square root of 7 minus 8 square root of 7 is equal to 0, then equal to 0. Then the result is 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, 4 minus the square root of 7 is a solution of the equation x square minus 8x plus 9 is equal to 0. Thank you for watching. For more videos on mathematics, please don't forget to subscribe.